The digital era has done this, and no one is willing to confront that. They're not. It's not democracy dies in darkness. It's not the truth is more important there. It's let's make money feeding our specific ideological audience in the District of Columbia and Manhattan. Let's confirm what they want to know.
I am joined by James O'Keefe, the founder and president of Project Veritas, a nonprofit dedicated to investigating corruption, dishonesty, waste, and fraud in both public and private institutions. James, thank you so much for being here.
Great to be here.
Can you tell me a little bit about the kind of work that Project Veritas does and how you go about investigating corruption?
We expose things in with tape. We show people in their own words. Like the tape we released this week on ABC News featuring David Wright, the veteran correspondent, revealing, confirming suspicions that we have, but we've never been able to prove it. So we have audio to back up our quotes, and I believe the type of journalism we do is the purest form of investigative reporting. Just let people talk and exposing the sacred cows, the Fourth Estate, government institutions, the sorts of places the media does not want to talk about. That's what we do. We do it well. We're growing, and we're at CPAC here, about to give a speech on Saturday on the main stage.
That's very exciting. Now, tell me a little bit more about the story that you all broke at ABC and with correspondent David Wright.
This is a story broke on Wednesday. It's a tape of Wright, who's a veteran correspondent, admitting that his bosses at ABC News don't see an upside in reporting news. He also talks about how they don't care about voters, And it's the media's broken, he says. And he talks about Good Morning America, and he says they're more interested in selling Marvel Avengers comic book products for Disney than they are in telling the news. Things that don't shock you and I, but to hear their own news person say it. Now, he did not think he was being recorded, but he did know he was talking to his colleagues. So we break this tape. ABC suspends David Wright, says that they don't allow bias, their network, and the mainstream media, again, attacking me, instead of reckoning with the truths that Wright admitted to. He also called himself a socialist, not just a democratic socialist. David Wright says, I'm an out-and-out socialist. But he also says that the network ABC doesn't give Trump enough credit for what Trump does right. No one's talking about that part of the tape. The media is obsessed with his admission that he's a socialist and is implying that he was fired because he's a socialist, or suspended because he's a socialist.
Why do you think that the progressive media is so adamantly against President Trump?
According to the people on the tape, they make the argument that they do not go out and talk to voters. They are kind of stuck together in Manhattan or Los Angeles. They're cocooned together, and maybe they need to start having conversations with people who don't see the world the way they do. And again, don't take my word for it. Just listen to what the people on this tape say. And they don't do an effort to care enough about what voters care about. And instead of practicing introspection, they're sort of doubling down. And this is what we're exposing inside these news agencies. They're just not willing to face the facts of what's going on. And it's becoming a huge problem for voters who watch Good Morning America and think they're getting real information. But according to their own news people, they're getting a bunch of propaganda.
So how widespread do you think this corruption is among the media? I mean, is this, you know, we have ABC and maybe a handful of other very mainstream media sites that are, you know, intentionally hiding information and really bashing Trump, or can we really trust any of them?
No, you can't. You have to be skeptical of what you see and hear. The CNN tapes we did, this was Patrick Davis saying, you know, it's sad what we've become. We could be so much better than we are. They're so interested in appointment viewership. The Washington Post is chasing digital clicks from they're serving their audience. They're doing the sort of things they would accuse the Heritage Foundation of doing. They're doing to a worse degree because they don't have the reputation for being partisan. Their democracy dies in darkness. Oh, the truth is more the most trusted name in news. And they're actually worse for democracy because they're not willing to admit on the record what their motivations are. And they've come out this week say, I'm in bad faith. I'm operating in bad faith. What am I doing in bad faith? I'm just letting people talk. So it seems to me they're not willing to face the brutal reality, and it's only going to get worse for them if they don't.
What do you hope is the message that the mainstream media takes from this story that you all just broke at ABC?
Have the moral courage to say the things you're saying privately, publicly. Because if you work for a news agency, arguably you have more power than maybe a branch of government. In fact, most people in government, all they do is go on the morning shows on ABC and CBS. So you work for these programs, you have a duty to, you have responsibilities as much as you have rights. We have First Amendment rights. Well, I get it, but you also have a responsibility to tell the truth. And if you're not willing to say the things you're willing to say privately, publicly, then that means you don't have integrity. There's a lack of integrity in the news agencies. And again, I am not alone in saying this. I just say it publicly. And I back up my claims with quotes from them, and there's audio of it. So they got to stop attacking me and attacking Project Veritas, and they have a reckoning with what they actually believe in and who they actually are. Because what's going to happen is more insiders are going to come public, come to us, because they don't trust the Washington Post and the New York Times, so they come to Project Veritas.
Yeah, yeah. Tell me about some of the other stories that you've been really proud to break and uncover at Project Veritas.
We've done, I mean, you name it, the topic. I mean, education issues, teachers unions, most recently. We got sued for reporting on a teachers union cover-up of someone that was alleged to have raped an eighth-year-old girl. And they sue me, and we don't settle the lawsuits. We've reported on Bernie Sanders' campaign recently, people praising gulags, talking about the Soviet Union as misunderstood. The sorts of things that we suspect Mr. Sanders believes, he said in the debates that they had a great literary program. And nothing happened to these staffers. Nobody asked any follow-up questions or put pressure on the campaign. It's pretty extraordinary series of events when the leading contender for the presidency has staffers praising communism and gulags and violence against police officers. Nothing happens. I tend to think that a lot of people probably agree with what that staffer said, which is itself an indication of how far we've fallen. And then last year was the Amy Robach, I'm wearing the hat, Epstein cover-up. That was the tape involving the leaked hot mic moment of the anchor saying that they squashed the Jeffrey Epstein story to protect the Clintons.
Hmm. Wow. So tell me about where you get your news. Are there news sites that you feel like you can trust and that they're going to report the facts?
I read everything.
Okay.
I read everything. I watch MSNBC, Morning Joe. I listen to CNN, although I feel like I have to take Tylenol after I do so. I read the New York Times. I read the Financial Times. I browse Twitter. I do all the I'm skeptical. And you have to learn. You have to learn to not trust what you see. You have to know how to triangulate the information and say, well, there's some things missing here. And as long as you do that and you practice extreme skepticism, I think you'll be okay. What we try to do is we don't report anything unless there's tape of it, right? Mm-hmm. So this firsthand account. And I would hope that people would do the same. I don't think you should trust anything unless you can see and hear it. And they say, well, you don't know if it's doctored. Well, first of all, name the edit, name the specific example of what we've doctored. But moreover, why should we trust something unless there is tape of it? Because you've given no reason for us to trust you in the mainstream press. In fact, you keep relying upon anonymous sources, and then whenever we actually find out about these things, it's not exactly what we were led to believe is true. Washington Post has printed 8 retractions about me. Eight. I haven't made a retraction in 9 years.
Wow.
So they're kind of doing the same things they accuse us of. They're going to have to practice introspection, have a reckoning at some point. I don't know when that'll happen, but I think with all these insiders coming out, it's bound to happen this year.
So how do you all actually go about getting those tapes? Are those your folks at Project Veritas going into situations and talking with people? Are people sending you those
tapes?
Both. Okay.
Both. We have 2 different ways. We have the insiders, and we literally give them a camera. These are brave souls. These are kind of, I call them unicorns, people willing to lose their jobs for the public's right to know. And then we have our undercover people who sometimes go in and support, assist, investigate the claims of those people, just like any investigative person would. And on Saturday here at CPAC, we're going to have the CNN insider, the person who recorded Jeff Zucker, the president of CNN. He's going to be on the main stage. And we were able to raise him $100,000 to pay for his family's issues after he lost his job working for CNN. And he believed so strongly. He said, there, for me, there was no other option. There was no choice. It was a choiceless choice. I had to do this because of how the network had become a nightmare for me instead of being my dream.
Hmm. interesting. You mentioned Twitter earlier, and now with the rise of social media, you know, really anyone can be a journalist. How have you seen social media really affect the field of journalism and honest reporting?
It's become more tribal. People don't talk to each other anymore. Like I call them the blue checkmark brigade. These are the verified accounts. I'm not verified on Twitter. I have 720,000 followers. The only person I know who has more who's not is Dave Portnoy of Barstool. I don't know of many people with a million followers who are not verified. And I think that there's a lack of conversation. Like the New York Times, this is to answer your question about social media. Sofin Deb, I've forgotten her last name is Deb, of the New York Times, was saying, James, you know, she wouldn't mention me by name. These people operate in bad faith. And she wouldn't tag me. She wouldn't mention my name. And she ascribed motives to me. She said, I operate in bad faith. What does that mean? Does that mean that I'm unpure in my heart, that I hate? I don't know how do they know I operate in bad faith? So them ascribing motives to who I am and why I do what I do when all I'm doing is letting David Wright talk, I think they're operating in bad faith. Washington Post headline, you know, O'Keefe scam. Well, what do you mean scam? What's scam about it? In fact, I would argue it's more pure than you with a headline ascribing what I do to be a scam. And the reason they do it is in the digital age, they have to appeal to their woke audience. They have to get more subscribers. Jeff Bezos bought the Post and has turned it into, from a venerable institution, has turned it into a woke clickbait farm, like much like a blog, you know, 15 years ago. And the digital era has done this, and no one is willing to confront that. It's not democracy dies in darkness. It's not the truth is more important. It's let's make money feeding our specific ideological audience in the District of Columbia and Manhattan. Let's confirm what they want to know.
Yeah. James, how can our audience follow you, find out more information about Project Veritas?
ProjectVeritas.com/brave, B-R-A-V-E. You can either be a journalist, you can work for us, you can be an insider. You know, you at the Heritage Foundation, you do a lot of work with the government. There's an alternative way to make a difference. You can put a camera on your body and record what you see. And if what you're seeing is in your workplace in Washington, D.C. is really bad, and the public must know it, I think you kind of have a right to, people have a right to see that. And I don't think they're going to retaliate against people as long as you make that evidence public. We do that. So the answer to the question, what can I do? We're the answer to that question. Wear a camera, send us the footage, we'll have your back.
Thank you so much for your time, James. We really appreciate it.